So what is happening now is basically here a very important comparison is here that Kali Yuga is compared to a kukkur. Kukkur means dog. So Kali Yuga is compared to a dog. If you want to kick out the dog, because many times, you know, the street dogs, you know, sometimes come, right? Nowadays it's gated community and all this there, but still, if there is an open layout and all this, the street dogs come in, and then usually we feel, sometimes we, out of compassion, we give them something and kick them out. You know, we may not entertain, right? We want to kick it out. It's a disturbance many times. If there is a festival and they just make their tongue and, you know. We worship the cows, but dogs we don't worship. The divinity, the manifestation of divinity is higher in the cows. The dog is not very much worshipped in the Vedic culture, right? For Atma Shreyas, the development of the soul. So that is where we see Kali Yuga means people will take more dogs. They will not worship the cows, but they'll take more dogs because they'll do everything opposite, right? We have to worship the cow. We have to take care of the cow. We have to serve the cow because that will give the peace of mind automatically. Govindo Govidampatihi. Govindo Govidampatihi. Automatically, the knowledge of the Vedas will come in the heart. If one is serving the cow, simply feeding it and developing affection for the cow is a very powerful mechanism for, like, causelessly or unknowingly, the Atma Gnana will come, the knowledge of the soul. If you are in the companionship of the cows, the knowledge of the soul will arise. And the lust also will go down by doing the manual service to the cows. Because all the divinity is there, all the Vaishnavas are there in the cow. Lakshmi Devi is there, Radharani is there, so... So in that way, when you serve, you get the same benefit. They say the heart becomes very simple if somebody is serving the cows, cleaning their place and other things. Reduction of the tendency to enjoy this material world, you know, matter. The greed for matter will go down serving the cows. So a lot of opportunity. You know, the Vedic culture has given us a lot of opportunity to reduce the kama, because kama is a disturbance. You know, it will not satisfy us. It will simply increase anxiety, stress, greed, all these things it will increase. And the thirst will increase. So, in the plant, tulsi plant, if somebody has a tulsi plant and if somebody has cows, perfection of life is guaranteed. Of course, we need to hear from the acharya to understand the glories of these things. But then such a beautiful thing, right? Such an easier method. Take care of your tulsi plant. Take care of the cows. Then automatically the heart will be pacified. And there will be some unknown, some causeless happiness. It's called causeless happiness. You'll be content. Previously, village life was like that. A lot of tulsi plant was there. Every house would have so many cows. And they used to keep the names for the cows. And then serving the cows. And then amazing immunity. Cow's milk gives amazing immunity. Cow urine. Cow milk. Cow, even the smell of the urine is so powerful. So automatic immunity. The cow dung, cooked food is the greatest food. And then if you see in the Bhopal gas tragedy, the houses where the cow dung was pasted, they were not affected by the poisonous gas chamber. Poisonous Union carbide gas. And then even today, my friends, many of them are doing the Agnihotra with the cow dung patties. And then they will simply burn it by telling the Mahamantra. Like the Nandi Maharaj is not nothing complex. You just have to keep the photo of the Panchatattva and Radha Krishna and burn the offer as offering, burn the patties. Sing the Nama Sankirtanam and burn the patties. And that smoke, the beautiful smoke is very good for immunity and other things in the house. So like that, life was simple. Now we have to invent so many vaccines, so many research and all. But then by God-created products also we can develop immunity. But unfortunately, we don't have faith. And society is in complex. You know, so Kali Yuga means complex. Ka means complex. You know, they make everything complex. means they have to do everything, some processed and some complex chemistry and all they will do. Whereas you will ignore the holistic simplicity which God has created. Along with creation, the diseases are also created, the medicines are also created. So by the knowledge of that, we can protect ourselves. Right, so I was hearing.
Yes, yeah, as cows, yeah, just seeing them itself, that we get that sattva guna, that kind of, you know, they are so.
Correct, right.
They are so, yeah.
And it is already
told about dog. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. No, it can. Yeah, dogs will not elevate us. Of course, as a soul, you can.
No, but rajo guna, I have seen. No, I have. They are always very aggressive. Right. Even the people become like that, associating with the dog.
Correct. It was not recommended in. It is not recommended in the shastra. It can be outside somewhere, but not that every day you are going embracing it and all. You have to embrace the cow. Already in the West, it is proven the stress is reducing. The stress is reducing by embracing the cow. You give a hug to the cow, they're saying that anxiety, stress is reducing. There's already, even though faithless people, they're experiencing that. There is a vibration. So everything carries energy. That is what we have to understand. Animals, and you know, we have to be careful. Like in the West, it is very popular to have the cats and the dogs in the house, roaming around everywhere, dogs and cats in the house. Man, it is very dangerous. Means the vibrations are different. You can give them milk a little bit, that's fine. But not having, associating with them always. Yes, cows, they're saying 33 crore demigods are present. The urine, the position of the urine is Lakshmi Devi, Radharani is present. Shakti Tattva is present in the urine position. The glory, you know. So the service of the cow is a very glorious thing. It will elevate the soul. See, the Vedic literature, finally, the target is Atma Shreyas, the eternity, eternity we have to realize. We should not just be consumed in the temporariness. Moment you come in touch with these things, your eternity, the concept of eternity rises in your heart. The principle of eternity is that I'm an eternal individual. I'm not a deteriorating individual. I'm not simply, you know, some chemicals. I'm expansion of divinity itself. I'm expansion of the divinity itself. I'm amsha of the divinity. That concept will start flowering. Of course, the Acharya Vakya is very important. All this get activated. Cow, Tulsi will get activated because of the Acharya Vakya. Like, the moment I came in touch with Prabhupada teachings, books, all this got activated, right? I also not having much this one. But moment you come in touch with Prabhupada books, it's an avatar. Prabhupada books is an avatar for the Kali Yuga. The way he has presented for a scientific approach. So that will activate. The Acharya blessings will be there and it will activate the tattvas, your vision and everything. So Kali Kukkura, so this dog, if you want, Kali is a dog. We cannot have Kali inside the house. So how do you not have the dog of Kali inside the house? If you do the Gaura Kirtana, Sachinandan Kirtana you have to do. Then the easiest way, first you have to do the Sachinandan Kirtana, Kali will go out. That means Bhaya will go out, fear. See, fear will go out. Kali means fear. More fear, always fear, because forgetfulness of divine, no? So forgetfulness of divine means fear increase. The moment you can do their own test, the fear is increasing, you can know that I have not associated. I have not associated last 15 days with any literature of the Shastra. I have not heard any Acharya Vakya, or I have not associated devotee. Then fear will increase, simply fear. But you know, if you're feeling fearless because you're doing the Kirtana and all, where you're associated, then you will feel fearless. So this Shastra is not that simply after 100 years, you will go to some loka. Here and here, we have to experience the results. Prabhupada says here and here. That means moment somebody is following Krishna consciousness, his bhaya should go down. He's following properly, means bhaya, immediately you'll feel relaxed. Hey, beautiful, this anxiety is going down for me. Now I have the concept of life. I'm not greedy or too much thirsty for this very dirty things. You know, all the enjoyment of this world is dirty. Dirty enjoyments. No, everything is dirty. That is like dog. Dog is always feeding on some things, right? So this dirty enjoyment is cleansing. Sachinandana Gava. So please, because Sachinandana is a recent avatar, most recent and most merciful. So we cannot directly go to Krishna. We should not actually. We should, because the power transmission is happening through Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Gauranithai. That's why Prabhupada installed Gauranithai everywhere. So we have to start our day with Gauranithai and end our day also with Gauranithai. That is where Samsara Davanala, if you see the first solution is Mahaprabhu Kirtana Nritya Gita. Unless we do Mahaprabhu Kirtana, how can we get out of this effect of Kali or the fire of Samsara? Mahaprabhu Kirtana Nritya Gita, the first solution, the first mercy is Mahaprabhu Kirtana. Mahaprabhu Kirtana Nritya Gita, dancing in like Mahaprabhu, dancing in Kirtana. It's okay, alone we can dance, you know, that is also good. What is the problem? How's we can dance? We can sing the Hare Krishna Mahamantra or any bhajan, we can dance in our own rooms in front of the photographs. The same effect. Now it's COVID time, no problem. You can do a lot of meditative dancing, you know. Don't worry, anybody is seeing. The Lord will see. And like Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami, many times he used to speak. Only one person will be there. He'll speak Harikatha. He says, no problem, speak to the walls. Dance. The Lord is everywhere. The Lord is in the wall. The Lord is in the pillar of the house. Everywhere he is there. So dancing, Mahaprabhu, is also very good for, it's an exercise, it's an immunity enhancer, and it's also very good for the soul. Mahaprabhu Kirtan, singing and dancing is the dharma of Kali Yuga. You have to take the God's name and in your own style, you can sing and dance. That is very powerful. Mahaprabhu Kirtana and Ritya Gita. And also various songs, like Gita means songs, Kirtana means Nama Kirtana. Vaditra Madhyan Manasorasena. You can use some instruments. Not that you need not be professional. You can use some instruments still, you know. You can just Vaditra Madhyan Manasorasena. Romancha Kampa Shutranga Vajra. It will Romanchana will come. Vande Guru Shri Charanarvinda. So Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan, you die. Moment morning, you take Sachinandan away. Immediately out of waking, take the name of Sachinandan. You know, the Kali will go away. Shout Gauranithai. Loudly do Sachinandan, Sachinandan. You know, that's very powerful. Repeatedly do Gauranithai. And Bhakti Raksha Shridharadeva Goswami always, in between the Harikatha, I used to say Nithaoi Gaur Haribol. He used to say Nithaoi Gaur. Then speak some 10 minutes Harikatha. Again, he will say Nithaoi Gaur Haribol, Nithaoi Gaur Haribol, Gaur Haribol. Because the very power is there. Thai Gauranga. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur is telling that it will drive away the baya, the fear of Kali. And then, of course, Gadadhara Madana. So Madana means there is a Madhurya relationship here and here, right? Madana. Because Gadadhara Pandit is Radharani. Nithayar Pranadhan is the life force of Nityananda Prabhu. Advaita Prapujita Gaura, and then worshipable Lord for Advaita Acharya, who is Mahavishnu. Nimai Vishwambara. See, Vishwambara. Vishwambara means he gives shelter to the whole year. Just like Lord Krishna provided shelter during Govardhan Leela to all the Vrajavasis. Gauranga Mahaprabhu provides for all Vishwambara. Nimai Vishwambara. Srinivasa Ishwara. Bhakta Samuha Chitta Chora. So he will rob away our Chitta. He will Chitta Chora. He will attract us. He will take away. And he's the moon of Nadiya. Nadiya Sashadara. Sashadara Shashi. Shashi means moon. Nadiya Sashadara Mayapura Ishwara Nama Pravartana. So what is the goal of this avatar? Nama Pravartana. He's distributing himself through the Nama. He's distributing himself through sound. He's distributing himself through sound. So service of the sound is most important in Kali Yuga, as you all know, right? Everything begins and ends with sound. The God is present in the sound in Kali Yuga. Every religion gives prominence to sound. So let's not make life complex by going to other things. Other things can be done because sometimes we use it to attract people. If you are a serious devotee, we are interested in serving the sound, because from the sound, everything will come. From the sound, everything will come. So even while taking darshan of the cows, we have to chant the namam. Nama should be there. Tulsi Devi, we should have the nama. Everywhere, nama. Nama pravartana, because the recent avatara, 500 years back, has given the prominence to the nama and distributed all the assets, all the wonderful gifts through the Nama. Through Nama Seva. Drink the Nama through the years. chant through the vibrate through the tongue and drink through the ears. The nama should be drunk through the ears. Then grijana shikshaka, then because of that you will get the instruction. Even your householder, you will get the instruction through the nama how to perform. See, many times we don't like, if you're chanting, you after some time, if you have a question, you keep the question in your heart, and if you're chanting, in 3-4 days you will get the answer. You know, we have to be sensitive. Some omens will come, some direction you will get, obviously. We need not go here and there too much, you know. Gradually you can find all answers through the nama. But we have to be alert. There's some indication, some signs will come. Then after some time, you'll get practiced. Oh, this is the direction. Of course, there are some shlokas and all you can chant. Then the direction will come. Like all Bhagavad Gita. And then every life incident, you will have some parallel incident. If not exact, perfect matching, some matching incident in Mahabharata or Ramayana or Bhagavatam. You'll have some matching incident, right? So we can take that as an example and read some shlokas from that. Then beg to the Lord for mercy, for support, and then you'll get the answer. You'll get the direction. Then, you know, that's a very powerful process. So, Grihijana Shikshaka Nyasikula Nag, even for sannyasis, he is the leader of the sannyas. Madhava Radha Bhava Pura. Who is this Madhava? Who is this Gauranga Mahapura? It's a combination. When Madhava has taken the Radha Bhava, completely engulfed, Pura means completely engulfed with Radha Bhava. When Madhava is completely engulfed with Radha Bhava, he becomes Gaura. Right? Sarvabhama Shodhan. And then the relationship. See, when we want to please the Lord, we have to. This why this song is so beautiful, and then why it will immediately give us the mercy of Mahaprabhu, because it is using the reference of so many devotees who are very dear to the Lord. Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, Gajapati, Maharaj Prataprudra, Ramananda Poshanavir, Ramananda Rai, Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami. And then, so that's why the song is very powerful. Immediately you will get the Mahaprabhu mercy by singing his song. So previously we saw all the Panchatattva, Gadadhar Pandit, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, you know. This is the power of this song. We get the Mahaprabhu's mercy by invoking the devotees. And what he does is Rajarasa Bhavana. So, okay, he is doing the Nama Pravartana. But inside the Nama Pravartana, what is it distributing? Is the Rajarasa. Rajarasa means the relationships of Vrindavan. The affectionate, the delightful relationships of Vrindavan is being distributed through the Nama. Rajarasa Bhavana, Dushtamata Shatana, Kapati Vighatana Kama, Shuddha Bhakta Palana, Shushka Jnana Tadana, Chalabhakti, Shuddha Bhakta Palana. Dushtamata means, see, there is a counterfeit. So we have to, you know, even in religion, there will be a lot of false opinions. That will also be this one and all, right? All 360 degrees will be there. Like in any product you take, you know, a mobile phone, you'll have very good product, ideal product, then you'll have a lot of counterfeits, opposition, like that. In every field, this world is like that. There will be some pure goodness, and then there will be mix of that, there will be contaminations and all this. So, based on our qualification and our aspiration, we will get attached to something. So, Dushtamata, we have to be careful. But if we worship Mahaprabhu, automatically we will not be drawn towards the Dushtamata, which will not elevate our soul. It will be more for the body, not for the enhancement of the soul. So you'll know that, because that kind of Dushtamata will be encouraging the sensual greed only in the name of religion. Kaitava Dharma, it's called Kaitava Dharma. Kaitava means cheating religion, which will use religion to enhance the material, but it will not give a concept of happiness by nature, by the soul. So, that is Dushtamata. Kapati Vigatana Kama. Shuddha Bhakta Palana. Shushka Jnana Tadana. Chalabhakti Dushana Rama. Shushka Jnana. Shushka means which is not doesn't have the essence, like the paddy, you know, paddy, after the paddy is the rice is removed, it is shushka. It looks like paddy, but inside the rice grain is not there. So like that, there are so many knowledge, like simply going on seeing about corona. What is the point in too much knowledge about this COVID and all the seeing news channels, seeing so many researching. So we research about the Atma and the Lord. That is the real knowledge, the knowledge of the soul, the knowledge of eternity, the knowledge of love, which is invisible. And people have said, no, I will study only visible things. Then that is Shushka Jnana, because finally the visible things, too much if you study, Mayara, Mayara Vidya, Jadera Vidya, Mayara Sama, Jada Vidya. What is Jada Vidya? It is Mayara Samana. It is equivalent to illusion. It will increase the illusion. As we go deeper, 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 you'll get struck in the illusion, complexities. So Jadera Vidya, Mayara Samana. It's a Shushka Jnana. The happiness, finally, complete happiness you will not attain. We may attain some fame, name, and all, and with its own complexity, and then we'll feel at the time of death, nothing I've achieved in my life, because it's all empty. That is a problem. But in the soul level, you will really be happy. You'll feel the gradually, or initially you may not feel, but gradually you feel your purna puraita punyaha, purna purnata, completeness. You're experiencing inner completeness. Outside people will think, what is this person? Nothing, he has not done any achievement externally. But the person will feel inside the growth of completeness, the growth of contentment, the growth of peace, parashanti. The growth of, not affected by any external. That's a beauty, right? We have to go on sticking to this process. And like the wine, no, as it is old, it is more tasty. Like that, the spiritual life is you have to stick on. And when you're sticking on, really you'll relish in the old age. You'll have some some sense, you know, this beauty. The Chalabhakti Dushana Rama, Chalabhakti Dushana. Chalabhakti means, see, this Dushtamata is outside the groups. They will not be in our path and all. But Chalabhakti is inside. They will be the same process, but they will be doing Chalabhakti. Means they will wear nice dress, tilaka and all this. But then they will be cheating. Cheating others and themselves also. That means they'll be having some other agenda for bhakti, not for spiritual growth, but for some achieving some material ends. Dana, Jana, Sundari, Kavita. You know, that's what. So like that, this song is a very powerful song to kick out the Kali. The Kali which has to be kicked out by invoking the sound, the Nama of Sachinanda, by singing about Sachinanda. So please take shelter of this song. You know, it's a very nice song. You can sing in your own tunes and other things. Now we'll go to this Bhagavad Gita. I think we'll finish in 40
this minutes. Is though, yeah. This is Bengali, looks law, I mean mostly Sanskrit, right? This I don't know.
Yeah, you're right. Initially it appears, but it is all the technical words are all Sanskrit only. Madana, Pranadhana, Prapujita, it's all Ishvara, everything is Sanskrit. So as you initially it appears foreign, but as you go a little nearer, you can understand, right? A lot of things. Most Indian language, Kannada also has Nama Pravartana word is there for distribution. Nama Pravartana Sura. Sura is also there. Any Devata is called a Sura, divine things. Asura and Sura. So Sannyasi, Grihi Jana means Grihastha. So you're right. So we become sensitive. As we become purified, we'll feel it easily, the lyrics. You're right. So
yeah.
Every song, I think we can, you can find now. After some time, you can relate to this. You don't feel the Bengaliness of that. Good. So, we'll discuss 10-15 minutes Bhagavad Gita, and we are in the Sankhya Yoga. I think where we are is the Lord is, because knowledge of the soul is very important. All our problem, even today, now also, the fear is because of lack of knowledge of the soul. So everybody has to read about the soul every day because of a lot of news channel death. Once you read about the soul, we'll get the right perspective of death, that the death is not there. It is just a change of body. You know, even though we know it, we'll not know it. The Maya will cover that knowledge, even for devotees. So we have to keep on reading about the soul so that we're not affected by unnecessarily and spending a lot of time in the anxiety. And the anxiety is itself has its own problem. The news channels will make a lot of music and they will aggravate this. So by defeating, by reading Gita second chapter, you can really defeat it, all those things, right? So 27, what he is telling is, because the first problem is I'm killing, no? That is why the first problem has to be tackled, Arjuna's. So it's a psychological treatment. It's a psychological treatment for Arjuna, Bhagavad Gita. You know, through using Arjuna, he is also treating us psychologically. So when the soul knowledge is not there, people will go mad on it. All others will be temporary. The psychology without the soul knowledge. That's why Lord is telling first is soul knowledge. I have the soul. Then only I can tell the further concepts to solve your vishada. But the foundation, if you are in the bodily concept, I can't help your vishada. Temporarily, you may feel again the depression and all will come back. But if you're rooted in the concept of the soul and you're seeing the world as the soul vision, then your vishada will be permanent cure. So jatasya dhruva mrityur. So one, it is born as a mrityu. Soul is not born, so soul doesn't have death. So jatasya dhruva mrityur. Dhruvam janma mrityasya cha. So when it is dying, it's also again sure to be born. Tasmadaparya. So in this cycle, which is the nature of this world, why are you just go and discharge your duty? Action is more important, because simply worrying about life and death will not evolve your soul. You have to worry about action, the right action, because that action, when done properly with Buddhi Yoga, can elevate your soul. Bhagavad Gita, see, the action is the first thing, because everybody, first we have the body. Body has the action. We can't directly sit for hours together meditation. That is not recommended. That is after doing the nishkama karma. So the practice of acting without material fruits is a very good practice. That will lead to the rise of the soul. When we are doing a lot of profit-oriented, material profit-oriented action with the sankalpa of material profit, then soul will not rise. Even one ray of soul will not feel, not touch it. So we have to practice doing activities without material gain. Even though in a small way, we start it. There is no material gain for me. I'm doing it for the pure spiritual evolution and also the worship, the satisfaction of the Lord. That is nishkama karma, no? When the action is done, material action, anything, any action done with the material body. Because we still don't have the contact with the soul. So we can work with what we have. I have the body and mind now. So let me work that in the nishkama karma, right? So that's why he's saying, natam sochitam arasi. Just focus on your action. Now you're a kshatriya. You're an expert in warfare. You're a PhD in the warfare activity, you're a kshatriya. So now you fight it nicely, but do it for the, not for your brother, not for winning the war, not for killing Duryodhana or something. Do it as a service to the universe, do a service to the Lord without any material benefit. Don't expect any material benefit out of it. Oh, I'll become king or I will take revenge. No. Because as a kshatriya, the Lord expects me to fight, and that's what he has given me, this potential, and I have to enact it. I have to perform this action for his pleasure. And there is a bigger plan by which I am part of it. So like that. So everybody has a potential inside by birth, right? There is a potential skill already existing. Along with the birth, that seed of potential talent is already given. Everybody has. And they can use that to serve the Lord. And they can achieve perfection by that potential. That is where the Varnashrama Dharma was actually designed by the Lord to bring out the potential, the natural potential which is invested at birth in everyone, to bring out that only the Varnashrama. So broadly, the potential is of four types only. But then inside that, there can be so many variations. Brahmana means visionary, planning, strategy, who is having the bigger picture, you know, who is more in research oriented like that. Teaching, academics, all Brahminical. Yajna, Yajana, Pata, Patana. What is the spiritual flavor, right? And then Kshatriya means execution, administration, controlling people. Ishwara Bhava, they will have the leadership, natural leadership Bhava. they'll enjoy that. That is